shout out now to a story that I just love reading right now. This has to deal with our good friend Jeff Bezos and Amazon.
Oh yeah. Yeah. How's he doing?
Well, I mean, guys, this is historic. Amazon does not need public money after all. Paul, did you know this?
I was told that they needed it, that they couldn't grow without a public assistance.
Daniel, I when I shared this news to you, you were like taken aback.
Yeah. I mean, didn't Amazon say like, I don't know, like a year ago that they couldn't possibly, under no circumstances that have ever existed, they could never successfully, profitably make a company that they paid for themselves.
All right. So, why are we talking about this? Well, this harkens back to a story that we even covered early on in our radio days when Amazon was considering or humoring the idea of moving to New York. Now, moving to New York, this has to deal with that big, fake, wonderful, but fake, but wonderful and fake competition where Amazon was making all the cities across the United States fight for where their second headquarters are going to be at. You had some cities that wanted to name Jeff Bezos mayor for life, way to throw away your democracy. You had other cities like here in the city of Chicago that basically told Jeff Bezos, you could build your second headquarters here. You're not going to pay any taxes at all. Boy, oh boy, did we dodge that bullet, because guess who had been paying the taxes? We would have. But Jeff Bezos already had a location in mind. It was in New York, and he was demanding a lot. But thankfully, Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez stood up to Jeff Bezos, and right now, surprisingly, shockingly, their company is still there. They're still there in Manhattan. They're still there in New York, guys.
What?
Yeah. So the decision by the online giant to lease a 335,000 square feet of office space in Manhattan and employ over 1,500 employees in the consumer and advertising departments was first reported by the Wall Street Journal. The announcement roughly came 10 months after Amazon announced it was ditching its widely condemned plan to locate a second headquarters site in Long Island. So this online giant was going to be given $3 billion in tax incentives. AOC was among the plan's most vocal critics at the time, basically stating, why should corporations that continue to contribute nothing to the pot be in a position to take billions from the public? And that's a very good question, because basically Amazon was taking nothing but corporate welfare. Amazon was basically taking your hard-earned money so they could build their little second headquarters and not pay for it. But gee, I guess they had the money after all, and they don't need public money. And so now, to all the critics who were yelling at AOC when she stood up to Jeff Bezos and Amazon, to all the critics that were saying that she was completely out of touch, that you know she ruined a huge economic opportunity for the city of New York, where are you now? Because it turns out she was right the whole time. Bezos, he's not going anywhere. He's still in New York. And more importantly, he doesn't need the corporate welfare. So what's your excuse when you have to defend the next lobby group or corporation that's asking for a corporate welfare? Because apparently they don't need it. If Amazon doesn't need it, none of these other corporations need it as well. And AOC once again proves that she is right. And gee, wow, it's no wonder she was able to knock out Crowley, because you know, somebody like Crowley would have caved and bent over in many ways to please Jeff Bezos and Amazon. Paul, Daniel, take it away.
So as wonderful people that used to say AOC was nuts for making the decision, like I still like to see people that are like, I hate AOC. Why? She knocked jobs out of New York. Those jobs would have gone. It's like, no, they're there. And I also want to remind people now that, as always, you can tell someone really means what they're saying and is really in their principles when they move the goalpost, as we currently have now, where all the people that Kit mentioned who are like, AOC is terrible because she stole these jobs from New York, and they start getting on the ground crying, having a tantrum, are now saying, there would have been more jobs. Amazon said that they would have done 25,000. There's only 1,500. To which I would reply, look at our coverage of Foxconn. Foxconn promised, what, like 30 or 50,000 jobs in Wisconsin. Then that became 25,000 jobs, and then 15,000 jobs, and then 10,000 jobs. And then, well, maybe we only need like, you know, 2 or 3,000 jobs in here, and we're actually not going to do all these expansions. And all the land that Wisconsin stole from homeowners homeowners that we said we needed for an expansion, we're actually not even going to use. In fact, we're going to move all future expansions into Taiwan because that's actually a cheaper, better thing for us. But thanks for the billions and billions of dollars from you, Foxconn. I would just say that Amazon didn't promise anything. They just said that they were going to give 25,000 jobs. And AOC, at this point, is right, has the consistency. And if we go back historically, the 25,000 job claim means absolutely nothing. It's a marketing pitch, just like that design for the new headquarters. In reality, the amount of jobs that they were going to do was based off of market demand. And they're not going to be like, oh, I'm not getting a thing, I'm going to do this. The amount of jobs that they have is the amount of jobs they needed. So if they're saying it's a 1,500 jobs, that 25,000 was probably 1,500 jobs, maybe with like 500 sprinkled in for bonus to say they did something, but probably not.
Well, I always thought about it, even at the time, this is what, a year and a half ago or whatever, when there was the conversation about Amazon going into New York and people were saying, oh, it's going to generate all these jobs in New York. And even then it was like, don't you think it's going to be people who already have jobs at Amazon who relocate to New York City? And people say, oh, well, that will at least, you know, spur economic growth in the city because there'll now be more people to, you know, spend on consumer goods and, you know, the local economy and whatever. I'm like, okay, so you're going to spend X amount of taxpayer dollars and you're going to recoup or more than recoup that in economic activity within the city. That's the argument that you're making. That's kind of a little thin. It's a little thin, that argument. And here we are in a situation where now not only did the city not have to spend that money because Amazon clearly has the resources to build an office anywhere they goddamn well please, they went ahead and did it in New York. And now, certainly there are going to be people that work for Amazon that live in New York. Either they're people that already live in New York or people that are moving there from their California offices.
Or have connections with Jeff Bezos or someone in Amazon so they can have those jobs. But if you think that those jobs are going to go to average working class citizens in New York City,
but
sorry.
I would not mind seeing an economic breakdown of how much revenue went into the city as a result, how much annual revenue will go into the city as a result of Amazon moving there? Because,
you know,
I doubt very strongly that it will outpace the amount of money that would have gone from the city to Amazon.
And you know, I'm just going to say that real quick, that New York was ready to give him his own helicopter pad.
Why does he
need
it?
They don't need this. They have he's the richest man that has a public bank account. I think Microsoft what's his name?
Bill Gates
just knocked him off again. Yeah. Whoa. But they don't need this money. And if they ever say that they do, they're lying.
Right. And remember, you know, the very fact that they did this without corporate welfare, without public money, it should tell you guys something like, well, gee, Jeff Bezos, you have enough money to then also offer your workers affordable health care. You have enough money to make sure that your workers are given a livable wage and that they have benefits. But no, because you're a rich sociopath, because you are somebody who wants to have absolute power and no responsibility, you're somebody who wants handouts because that's what you want. You want public money handouts. You're just going to hoard your wealth. And only then, when pushed into a corner, because especially if you want something, you'll go for it because that's the kind of billionaire, I guess, that you are. That's the kind of person that you've always been. And when it comes down to actually, you know, caring about people, you don't care about people. You never even cared about this competition. You have the chance with all that money and resources to do good. But because you're selfish, because you're greedy, because you like money and politics, because you're able to buy off these politicians, you're able to get corporate welfare. But now at this one point, somebody with courage, Representative AOC, just showed the whole world what kind of backbone Amazon really has. And when push comes to shove, you guys don't need our money. In fact, no corporation needs our money, and we're going to keep it that way.